At first, we'll try to know what is FSM, a finite state machine. It is a machine that has many states and has a logical way to change from one state to another state. There are two types of FSM that generates output. First one is Mealy machine, second one is Moore machine. Now we will know about Mealy machine. A Mealy machine is a FSM who give us output that depends on the present state as well as the present input. It can be described by six tuples. Those are Q, sigma, delta, del, lambda, and Q naught. So in this slide, we will describe about Mealy machine. A Mealy machine is a FSM whose output depends on the present state as well as the present input. It can be described by six tuples. So where Q is the finite state, sigma is the finite set of symbols which is called as input alphabet, delta is a finite set of symbol which is output alphabet, del calls the transition function, input transition function, which maps Q cross sigma to Q. Lambda is the output transition function where it maps to Q cross sigma to delta. That means that it will depend on present state as well as the present input of that particular state. Q naught is the initial state from where any input is processed. Now we will give an example. In this diagram, there are three states, Q0, Q1, and Q2. For the value of any transition, we will get the particular output. In the diagram below the table, there we have transferred those values. For the particular input, we will get the value. In next slide, we will discuss about Moore machine. Moore machine is a FSM whose output depends only on the present state. So it has also described by six tuples, Q, sigma, delta, del, lambda, and Q naught. Q is the finite state of states. Sigma is the input alphabet. Delta is the output alphabet. Del is the input transition function which maps Q cross sigma to Q. And lambda is the output transition function which maps Q to delta. That means it will only depend on the current state. Q is the initial state where input are produced. So in the next slide, we'll give an example of Moore machine. Here we can see there are three states, Q0, Q1, and Q2. For Q0 state, we will get the particular value output 0. For Q1 state, for any input, we will get the output 1. And for Q2 state, for any particular input, we will get the output 0. And under this, the table is the Moore machine transition diagram. Okay. In next diagram. So in this slide, we will discuss the difference between Mealy machine and Moore machine. So Moore machine depends only on the present state. Mealy machine depends on the present state as well as the present state input. More number of states are required in Moore machine. Mealy machine requires less number of states. There are less hardware requirement for the circuit implementation for Moore machine. Mealy machine required more hardware to design it. The Moore machine react slower and the Mealy machine react faster. Moore machine is easy to design. Mealy machine is difficult to design.
Move on to a conversion of Moore machine to Mealy machine. So it can be done in three steps. Number one step is to take a blank Mealy machine transition table. And the second step is to copy all the Moore machine in transition states into its table format. And the last step is to check the present states and their corresponding outputs in the Moore machine state table. And if for a state QI output, if for a state QI output is M, we will copy it into the output columns of the Mealy machine state table wherever QI appears in the next state. So in the next slide, we look into the example of that conversion. So as mentioned above, we first draw a transition and table for the given mode machine. So as we can see that in the transition table of the mode machine, the output of each of the input are same because the output is associated with the present state. So like when Q0 is given the input 0, it goes to Q1, and when it is given the input 1, it goes to Q2, and the output will be 0 in both the cases. So by using the step 1, 2, and 3 as mentioned above, we will draw the transition table of the Mealy machine. So in Mealy machine, the outputs are basically associated with the input, so it will be different in different cases. So as Q0 is given the input 0, it will go to state Q1, it will produce the output 1, and when it is given the input 1, it will go to state Q2 and it will give the output 0. And Q1, when given input 0, it will go to Q1 and the output will be 1. And Q1, upon given the input 1, it will go to state Q2 and the output will be 0. And the same pattern follows for the state Q2. So from this transition table, we can draw a Mealy machine, which is shown in the right side. So in the next slide, we move on to a conversion of Mealy machine to mode machine. So it also can be done in 3 steps. Number 1 step is to calculate the number of different outputs for each state and each state that are available in the state table of the Mealy machine. And the second step is that if all the outputs of QI are same, we will copy paste QI, and if it has n distinct output, will break QI into n states. In the last step, if the output of the initial state is 1, we'll insert a new initial state at the beginning, which gives output 0. So in the next slide, we'll move on to an example of conversion of Mealy machine to mode machine. So first we draw a transition table of the Mealy machine. So in the Mealy machine, the outputs are associated with the given inputs. So when QI is given an input 0, it will go to a state Q1 and the output will be 1. And when Q0 is given an input 1, it will go to state Q2 and the output will be 0. And the same pattern follows for the states Q1 and Q2. So by using the step 1, 2, and 3 mentioned above, we will draw a transition table for the mode machine. So as the mode machine, in the mode machine, the outputs are associated with the present states. So it will be same for the different inputs. So when Q0 is given an input 0, it will go to Q1. And when Q0 is given an input 1, it will go to Q2, and the output will remain same 0 for all the inputs. So now Q1, when given an input 0, it will go to Q1, and upon giving an input 1, it will go to Q2, and the output will be 1 in both the cases. So the same pattern follows for Q2. So from this transition table, we can draw a diagram for the mode machine, which is given in the right side. So in the next, so from the next slide, we'll discuss some questions. So in this question, we are giving an input. We are basically given a binary input 10 10 10, and we have to predict the length of the output. So here the answer will be mod of input plus 1. So in the next slide, we have the next question. So in this question, so in mode machine, output is produced from the charge of, and here the answer will be states, option B.
output depends upon which condition. So millimeshing, the outputs depend on the state and the input. And the next question is the major difference between milli and Moore machine about, that is the output variation.
Thank you, sir.
Very good presentation. Remember, milli machine and Moore machine output alphabet, you have shown again the big delta 01. It can be different. It may be capital A, capital B. It may be two characters also, 0011. It may not be necessarily a single character. That is one thing. And in Moore machine and milli machine, Moore machine is much stable because number of states are more. Moore machine is stable. Milli machine may act on edges, so it is transient factor is the available. And another thing is Moore machine and milli machine, no such acceptance final state concept like in our deterministic finite automata. There is some accept or reject. This is it. Very good lecture. Thank you.